Thank you guys for being here. What did I miss? Okay, we're gonna start Mass Effect 2 today, which a lot of people have been, well, there's like 80% of people were like, Mass Effect 2 is the best in the series, and then a bunch of people were like, I disagree, so I don't know. I've never played it. Again, this is my first time, so Soraya, what's up? Thank you for the 7-month resub. Have some hamburgers. Slurpee, thanks for the 5 months earlier. Thank you. So the way we're gonna start this, or wait, hang on. Gray Blue One, thank you for the bits, is to help with the PAX travels. Have some good coffee on me. Thank you. I will need coffee all weekend. I'm only gonna be gone for 2 days though. It's pretty short for me. Well, I mean, I'll be gone from streaming for 4 days because I have to travel, and then 2 days and then travel again, so. Let's see. I lost my page. Oh, there it is. Okay, cool. So we're gonna play Mass Effect to start off with. I feel like this is the one that I watched Aaron play some of, so I've like seen it before, but I didn't pay attention to any of the story or anything. So, the way that I'm going to start it, people were asking, is that there's a DLC called the Genesis DLC, which allows you to, like, make... It's, like, for people who didn't play the first Mass Effect, which I did, but it, like, gives you... It's supposed to give you, like, 6 questions that are, like, the basic main things that you decided in Mass Effect 1, so we're just going to go through that. I'm not importing my save because I'm pissed that Rex died. Here's where I will admit that I messed up with Mass Effect 1. Have you ever like had an idea about something and you can't remember where that idea came from, but you just remember that that idea exists and that it gives you, like, you have something in your brain and then you find out that you've been wrong the whole time. And that's what happened with Mass Effect 1 for me. So for all the people who, why I'm saying this is because for all the people who are saying, like, you shouldn't try and rush through Mass Effect, for some reason, I don't know why, I don't know where this came from, I don't know what this idea was. For some reason, I got it in my head that Mass Effect had a linear story like Halo or like Call of Duty. So I didn't understand when you guys were saying, like, don't rush through it, that it's not, that it's like an RPG. And I don't know why, I don't know where that came from, but for some reason, in my brain, it was like Mass Effect has a linear story from point A to point B, and then there's like other crap that happens. So that's why when I played Mass Effect 1, I just like went straight through it because, yeah, it has consequences, and I didn't realize that, and I just was so like hell-bent on just being done with it that I was not really paying attention. So I will admit that that was my mistake. I shouldn't have played it that way. But it happened, and we played it, and whatever. So now we're gonna go through the Genesis DLC. Thought you were running through because you wanted to finish fast? Well, both. I wanted to finish it fast, and that because I wanted to finish it so quickly, I, like, didn't pay attention to the fact that it's, like, your choices and the things that you're doing are, like, gonna have a consequence. I didn't realize that until Rex died. And by then, it's too late. So, that's why we're gonna do the Genesis DLC. I think pretty much I'm going to make all the same choices except for the fact that I was upset that Rex died. So I think that's the only thing that I'll probably change. This one, I'm assuming, everyone has said that the gameplay is a lot better, the like fighting and stuff is better. So I am planning on spending more time with like side quests and stuff like that. I wanted to admit that I had some kind of weird misconception that Mass Effect had a linear story and, like set in stone. And I don't know why. I don't know where that came from. But, whatever. Colonel Thread, what's up? Thanks for the sub. Welcome to the Armory. And Captain Dallas, thank you for the 28-month resub. Thank you so much for your support. Okay, so play. I don't know how long we'll play this. I know that there's new Overwatch stuff, so I'll probably... advice on early game DLC appreciated. Nope. I don't need advice for stuff. It's muted. This is like 4 pixels. Okay. I'm not sure how to make sure that the... Okay, this is it. You can access the included bonus downloadable content, take advantage of online features, must create an EA online account. I think I have that already. Hang on. EA online account. Is that my Origin account? I don't know. Is that my Origin account? I don't know. It's the same as Origin? Okay. I don't even know what my password is for that. I gotta look it up. Oh god, I have 2. RIP. Oh god, which one is it? This isn't good. Origin... doesn't have an email. We're gonna try this and see if it works. That's the wrong website. I just realized. Okay, hang on. Maybe I didn't change that one. Yes, we did. Okay. Accept terms and conditions. I know you can't see right now. I had to enter my email and stuff. Okay, Genesis. Does that mean that it exists? Okay, I also got the DLC. And here's why I got the DLC. Because I knew that if I didn't get the DLC, every 12 seconds, someone would come in here and say, does she have all the DLC? And chat would respond, she didn't get the DLC. And that person would take it as a personal affront that I didn't get all the DLC. And then they're going to be like, she should really get the DLC. Because the DLC is really important to Mass Effect. And that would happen like every 12 seconds. So that's why I got all the DLC so that when the person comes in and they say, did she get all the DLC? Chat can say, yes, she did. And then they will sit there quietly, hopefully, and watch the game. I wasn't going to do it. And then I was like, if I don't get all these stupid DLCs, everyone is going to be like, why didn't she get the DLC? Doesn't she know it's really important? And I'm like, I don't actually care. Why doesn't she care? Doesn't she want to have a good experience? Well, no, I don't actually. So, Infamous Butcher, what's up? Thanks for the 6-month resub. Did she get all the DLC? Yes, I did. Thank you for asking. I did get all the DLC. Is my gameplay acceptable to you? Am I playing the game the way that you want me to play the game? Good, because that's what's happening. Okay, and before we even start, I'm gonna check if the subtitles are on, because Talia's gonna be like, are the subtitles on? I can't hear anything. Oh wait, can we do, 1920 by 1080? Do we want Bloom? I don't... Film Grain! Do we want that? Wait, did that actually apply? Did that apply or it, nothing changed? I don't know what happened. I just, no, it's not that I'm hating on you. It's that I can predict what you guys are gonna say. Okay, we'll leave it on normal, auto level up. Points must be manually assigned using the squad screen. If I do this, squad only. Squad and player. I'm gonna use squad because I don't feel like caring about them. So, yes. Auto save. Great. Turn all the graphic settings on. Changes will apply when you go back to the main menu. All the graphic settings on. Were they all on? Dynamic shadows. I think my computer can handle dynamic shadows. Full screen. Okay. Yes, yes, yes. That should be good. That looks so much better already. DWK, what's up? Thanks for the tip. It says ME2. And yay. Okay, how do I go back? Oh, there's, I didn't see that thing. New game, are we ready? We'll go FemShep again. The graphics are already like 50 million times better than ME1. It's only like 3 years newer too, huh? Oh! We already did that. I'm ahead of the curve. I could import, but I'm not going to. Gameplay is better? Cool, I'm looking forward to it.
Shepard did everything right. More than we could have hoped for.
Commander Shepard uncovered the truth.
And still, it's not enough.
Oh, I remember her.
We're at war. No one wants to admit it, but humanity is under attack.
But they're sending her to fight Geth. Geth? We both know they're not the real threat. The Reapers are still out there.
And it's up to us to stop
them. Elusive man. Gross.
The Council will never trust Cerberus. They'll never accept our help, even after everything humanity has accomplished. But Shepard, they'll follow her. She's a hero, a bloody icon. But she's just one woman. If we lose Shepard, humanity might well follow.
Then see to it that we don't lose her.
What's up with his eyes? You have weird eyes. Oh god. 2183, the heart of the galactic community suffered a devastating attack. The Citadel space station was invaded by a synthetic Geth army attempting to open its portal for the Reapers. Yep, Commander Shepard led the defense, saving the Citadel, but at great cost. Now the Council attempts to quell rumors from the Reapers' impending return, hoping to ease public concern. Why? Okay, thanks for giving me 4 seconds to read 5 paragraphs. I really appreciate that. Ivan Stravinsky, yeah. Or Stravinsky? Stravinsky? Why am I saying Stravinsky? Stop saying Stravinsky. Strahovsky. Jesus Christ. Asian Insect, what's up? Thanks for the 5-month resub.
Disengaging FTL drives. Emission sinks active. Board is green. We are running silent.
Thank you for the 5-month resub.
4 days searching up and down this sector, and we haven't found any sign of Geth activity.
3 ships went missing here in the past month. Something happened to them.
My money's on slavers. The Terminus system is crawling with them.
Picking up something on the long-range scanner. Unidentified vessel.
Hey, it's Shepard.
Looks like a cruiser.
Doesn't match any known signatures.
Cruiser is changing course. Now on intercept.
Yeah, the DLC is supposed to start after this.
Stealth systems are engaged. There's no way a Geth ship could possibly.
It's not the Geth. Brace for evasive maneuvers!
That wasn't evasive, you just flew into the laser beam.
Presley!
And any barriers down. Multiple hull breaches! Weapons offline! Somebody get that fire out!
Hey, it's what's her face? Lena.
Shepard.
Distress beacon is ready for launch.
Will the Alliance get here
in
time?
Knew it. I don't. They'll be here.
The Alliance won't abandon us. We just need to hold on. Get everyone onto the escape shuttles.
Joker's still in the cockpit. He won't evacuate. I'm not leaving either.
I need you to get the crew onto the evac shuttles. I'll take care of Joker. Shepard! Liara, go!
It's not time!
Now!
No time for making out!
Aye, aye.
Did we date anybody? That one with the blue face.
Everybody in! Go, go, go!
Oh god. Oh god! What'd you do? I missed it. I was grabbing my chapstick. God, I'm playing. Go to the cockpit. Get to Joker on the upper deck. Okay. Oh God. Oh God. Hi, Lexi. You are late. But now that you're here, the game can finally begin. What? Why is it all quiet? Oh, I was like, why is it all quiet up here? Oh, we're in space. How is he alive? If there's a giant hole in the ship, talk to Joker. This is as fast as I can move, also. Oh, because there's like a force field thing.
Come on, Joker.
Oh, cool. He's got like
a
thing.
No, I won't abandon the Normandy.
No!
I can still save her!
Dude.
Normandy's lost. Going down with the ship won't change that.
Yeah, okay. Help me out.
Yeah, okay. Oh, God. Why is he still not up? Did she just break his arm? He has brittle bones, be careful! She is not being careful at all. This is actually the prequel to Gravity. You guys haven't seen that movie? Or... Okay. That was Mass Effect 2. Thank you guys so much for tuning in. Had a really good time. This is a great game. I clicked like three things and world record finish. We're gonna play some Overwatch now, so thanks for being here. Emily, what's up? Thank you for the 8-month resub. Cool, sweet, awesome. I really enjoyed that. Just kidding. That was that was definitely better than Mass Effect 1. Interactive backstory comic. Great, let's do it. I'm so ready.
Just another routine mission. Why do they always say that before a mission? Of course it's routine. You haven't done anything yet. It's everything that happens along the way. The choices you make, the paths you choose, that turn the routine into anything but. Of course, that's how it started. A routine mission, answering a distress call. And look where that got me. We were testing out the Normandy, Captain Anderson's new ship, when the distress call came in. An Alliance patrol on Eden Prime had been attacked. They'd seen something they couldn't explain. Whatever it was, it was massive. I hit the ground with my lieutenant, Caden Alenko. Good kid. Loyal, by the book. With a talent for biotics. We came across the lone survivor of the patrol. Gunnery Chief Ashley Williams.
Who's a huge racist.
Disciplined.
And a dumbass.
Came her way. Ashley joined up with us and took us to the
spot. This is them, this is them going through the Mass Effect 1 story. Guys, if... the number of people saying she didn't import her save, if you're looking at this, then clearly no, I didn't. I didn't import the thing.
We followed the path of destruction to an artifact, a beacon left by a long dead race called the Protheans. The colony had dug it up, and whoever attacked them had tried to take it. Lieutenant Alenko made the mistake of getting too close. Hit him with some type of energy. I grabbed him and threw him out of the way. That's when it hit me. Hard. Every muscle in my body went rigid. I couldn't move.
But why? Because I didn't want to import my save.
Everything went black.
I feel like these are questions that you could answer just by thinking
Vision.
About it.
Dream. A nightmare. By the time I woke up, we were halfway to the Citadel on our way to meet the Council. I was expected to explain what I'd seen. Anderson came along. So did Udina, our political representative on the Citadel. With those two heavyweights, it seemed reasonable we could persuade the Council that the ship we'd seen was a potential threat. As was the individual behind the attacks. The main suspect for the Eden Prime massacre was a Turian Spectre named Saren. He'd been seen by one of the survivors.
I think it's like black bars on the side of the screen.
There was some evidence to suggest that the ship was connected to Saren. But even Udina's pointed accusations weren't enough to convince the Council. They just couldn't believe one of their chosen elite specters could be guilty of something like that. They needed proof, which meant I needed proof. Fortunately, I wasn't alone in my search. Garrus,
Genesis doesn't transfer every detail. It'll transfer all the ones that matter, though.
Citadel security. Despite orders from his superiors that he shouldn't get involved, he told me he was suspicious of Saren and he had some useful leads. More importantly, he was willing to share them. That led me to Rex, the biggest, nastiest looking Krogan bounty hunter I'd ever seen. He turned out to be more than just a brute. It was his intel that led us to a fugitive with incriminating evidence on Saren. The fugitive turned out to be an energetic little Quarian named Tally. A tech expert with a knack for hacking, she procured some information on Saren. Evidence that proved Saren was dirty. Tally's evidence proved that Saren was responsible for the massacre on Eden Prime. And the immense warship we'd spotted was in fact Saren's flagship.
Minor stuff doesn't come with this comic, but it's not essential to the story. Then I didn't play it in ME1 anyway, so it wouldn't have mattered.
Machines from dark space. Machines allegedly responsible for cleansing the galaxy of all organic life. These Reapers were blamed for wiping out all life 50,000 years ago, including the Protheans. Then disappearing back through the mass relays to dark space, leaving no trace that they'd ever been. That explained why Saren was after the beacon. And it made some sense out of my visions. But not much else. We couldn't convince the Council that the Reapers were a threat. But they agreed Saren had to be stopped. They stripped him of his Spectre status and gave me the honor of becoming the first human Spectre. My first task...
And the music gets hopeful.
Bring down Saren. Anderson decided to stay behind, giving up his ship, the Normandy. He told me I'd need it more than he would. He also pointed me in a direction. Liara. A Prothean expert, adept in biotics, and maybe most importantly, daughter of Benezia, Saren's top lieutenant. And like most Asari, as beautiful as she is intelligent, and born with a unique ability to meld with other species, Liara was able to help me decipher some of the vision the beacon had given me. Nothing concrete, but it gave me some clues. And a new appreciation for the Asari. Her technique for accessing my vision was unexpected, but not at all unpleasant.
The way she talks about her is very,
Caden
as if they know that she was the one that I romanced.
I shared with Liara. As commander, I knew either relationship had the potential to interfere.
Oh, okay, here we go.
I told Liara about how I felt. Apparently, she felt
this
too.
Like
but we agreed we wouldn't let it get in the way of our mission, finding Saren.
I know, appreciation. The way she said that was so, like, intense.
Saren had taken her to Novaria, where he'd enslaved the queen of a dangerous race of insect-like creatures, the Rachni. He ordered Venezia to use the same technique Liara had used on me to extract information from the Rachni queen. Queen's drones were everywhere, and they were not happy. We had to fight through hundreds of them to get to Venezia. By the time we arrived, Saren was gone with the information.
I do like the art, yeah.
But Saren had indoctrinated her. He'd somehow acquired the ability to control people's actions and wills. Venezia wouldn't surrender, and Liara was forced to watch her mother die in her arms.
That didn't happen.
And I was left with an angry, dangerous Rachni queen to deal with. She claimed her drones would do no harm if I released her. But the Rachni had terrorized the galaxy before.
We saved the queen.
I couldn't do it. I wouldn't doom an entire species for past
We went after Venezia before we got Liara.
She left and took her army of drones with her. With Saren's top lieutenant dead, he was quickly running out of time and places to hide. I tracked him down at his base on Vermeier, but we soon learned it was more than a base of operations. It was a breeding ground. Saren was breeding an army of Krogan. He'd found a cure for the genophage, a disease inflicted on the Krogan to prevent them from breeding and taking over the galaxy. The Krogan Saren was breeding were slaves, mindless beasts that obeyed Saren's will. I had to destroy the base and all its research. Rex disagreed, violently.
But we saved Rex.
I tried to convince him to help me destroy it, that these Krogan weren't real. But he wouldn't back down.
We totally saved him.
Fortunately, Rex is smarter than he looks. He realized this wasn't the way to help his people, and that Saren was the real threat. When we finally got to the center of the base...
That's the whole reason that I did this, instead of importing my save.
He was already in communication with the Reapers. Sovereign, Saren's
you guys saw,
we'd
yeah.
all assumed was just a totally. Ship, was a Reaper. It spoke to me, threatened me.
That was a really cool scene.
It had for every living thing. It wanted me dead. It wanted us all dead. And I knew it was capable of doing just that. What I couldn't understand was why Saren would help it. But there was no time to think about it. Sovereign knew where we were. We had to destroy the base and get the hell out. I split my team into two squads, sending Ash with one
split
and
the party.
With the other as a distraction. We had a nuke and we planned to use it. Before we could detonate the bomb, Saren showed up. We fought. I stalled him to make time for my team. And in talking to him, I realized the truth. It wasn't Saren who was indoctrinating everyone. It was Sovereign, the Reaper. And Saren was in deeper than all of them. He tried to convince me he was still in control. Said he'd found a way to reduce the Reaper's influence. But he was kidding himself. Or believing the lies Sovereign was telling him. Before I could convince him to stop, he ran, leaving me just seconds to extract my squad mates. I tried, but it wasn't fast enough. I could only save one of them. Ash was a good friend.
She wasn't that good of a friend, and not that good of a soldier.
But I had to choose, and I chose Caden. That was the last time Saren would slip away from me. I knew then. The next time we met, one of us would die. With my team mostly intact, we chased Saren and his army to Ilos, a long-lost planet that had once belonged to the Protheans. As we prepared for what we knew...
Is that a picture of Ashley?
I spoke to my crew.
As if we cared.
Just one ship, against Saren's growing army. I assured them all that despite the odds, we could defeat him. But Liara saw through my words. She knew I was hurting after Ash's death.
No.
She could sense my doubts. We both knew this mission could be our last. Until that moment, we put our feelings aside for the sake of the mission. But why wait? We gave in to each other. And it was perfect. While it lasted.
Jesus.
We arrived on Ilos close behind Saren. Once on the planet, we discovered a Prothean databank that helped me put the final pieces of my vision together. The Reapers had come 50,000 years ago, and every 50,000 years before that, each time purging the galaxy of life. The Protheans had fought and died like every species before them, but a few survived long enough to leave a parting gift. The Protheans had discovered that the Citadel was the key to controlling the mass relays. By sabotaging the Citadel, they found a way to close the relays to dark space, slowing the Reapers' return, giving us the time we needed to find a solution to stop the Reapers once and for all. Saren knew this. He was leading his army to take control of the Citadel and re-establish the relays to dark space, bringing the waiting Reapers here to destroy us all. We followed him to the Citadel. It was intact, but heavily damaged. He'd caught the Council fleets by surprise, and they were only now regrouping. And with Sovereign as his flagship, there was little hope that the fleets could counterattack with enough strength to take back the Citadel. But Saren was done running, and I was done chasing him. As the Alliance and Council fleets battled Saren's army outside the Citadel, I cornered the Turian bastard in the Citadel Tower and confronted him. He died believing that the Reapers would save him.
And then he transmorgified into a giant monster.
As I fought to regain control of the Citadel, the Council's flagship, the Destiny Ascension, fell under attack. Despite Saren's death, Sovereign and Saren's army continued to fight. The Council was aboard the Destiny Ascension, and they were requesting assistance. But I knew in order to help them, I would have to put our human Alliance fleet in jeopardy. The Council had to be saved. They represented the hearts and minds of the galactic community. Without them, the fleets would be in disarray. Even with the Citadel back in my control, Saren defeated and the Normandy leading the combined galactic fleet, the battle against Sovereign, a single Reaper.
We saved them, yes. The only thing I've changed is Rex, the fate of Rex right now.
But in the end, Sovereign fell. The costs were immense. While humanity's efforts in the war earned us our first seat on the Council, it was a hollow victory. The Reapers were still out there. I knew the fight was far from over, but as the one who'd led the fight against Saren, I was given new responsibilities. The choice of humanity's first counselor was left to me to decide. On the one hand, Udina, the lifetime politician, ruthless and ambitious. He would easily navigate the political landmines that would soon be placed before him.
Udina!
The other choice, Captain Anderson.
Yay!
Premier soldier.
Arbiter.
Tough but fair. But a friend.
Keith, dude.
And someone I could trust. Both great leaders in their own right. Anderson didn't want the job, which was a sure sign he'd be perfect for it. No ambition to get in the way. The war was over. The threat had passed. In time, the Council would rebuild itself. The Citadel could be repaired.
Hard to get to know any character when you don't actually talk to them. We did talk to her enough for her to be like, are you sure we should trust these aliens?
And if they were all
they're aliens.
We had to find a way to stop them. I had to find a way. I gathered my crew, took my ship, and went in search of answers. Officially, the Council would only say I was assigned cleanup duty, routing out any remnants of Saren's army. Just another routine mission.
Hooray! Okay, yeah, that's everything I kept the same except for Rex. That's the only thing I changed. Drill, what's up? Thanks for the sub. Welcome to the Armory. Dalvorn with the sub. Thank you and welcome. Sound Guy, thank you for subbing. Welcome, guys. And Emily, I already got the email.
Commander Shepard has been recovered. The Lazarus Project will proceed as planned.
Hello? Is that supposed to be a heart? Because that is not healthy looking. That looked very messed up. Why is everything... Wait, so I'm a zombie? Because those were definitely not healthy looking organs. Wanman, what's up? Thanks for the 2 month resub. Have some hamburgers. She died? I didn't know she, like, actually completely died. I thought that she was just, like, out. Oh, Jesus Christ. Is that supposed to happen? It says loading. How do they bring you back to life? Enter subject's first name. Got it. Let's do custom, I guess. I don't know. Custom appearance. Oh, Jesus. Oh, whoa. I've only ever seen, like, redheaded Shepherd, so it's weird to me to, like, see her as other things. I feel like the only time I've ever seen her, she's looked like that. Facial structure. This is a lot of stuff. I could just make her super pale. Like a ghost. I mean, she did die. Go default. Default Shepherd, best Shepherd. Customize the neck length, neck thickness. Make her have a really thick neck. Turn her head. Wait, hang on. Oh! You look great. Whoa. She's better at makeup than me. Limit Guns, thank you for the 17 month resub. Have some hamburgers. On behalf of me and the subs, thanks for your support. I'm not gonna do that. I can't play a whole game with that creation, okay? I just can't. I can't do it, but that was fun. I enjoyed that. What about the long hair? I like the longer hair. She can have no eyebrows? Breathes out in relief. If I did that, I wouldn't be able to play this game is the problem. Like, every cutscene would just be ridiculous. The second custom one. That kind of looks like me, actually. I could try and make it look like myself. And I'm always bad at doing that, though. She has a very square jaw. I don't really have a square jaw. Let's see. This one? Are people gonna be upset if I... The way she moves is like... Toggle helmet permanently on. Yeah. Oh gosh. Um She looks very surprised all of a sudden. What? What? Oh, yes, I see what you mean. Oh my god, there's a bear! Oh god. Oh my god, what is the- What are those eyes? What? Alright, I like... these ones? Brow depth? What is that? Oh. What? Oh, wait. She looks just permanently surprised. Love it. I don't know. Whatever. I don't know. So much different from the side. Which one's which? Don't make her look like Samantha Trainor from ME3. I don't even know who that is, so... G-Nerd, what's up? Thanks for the bits. That was the best Shep I have ever seen. Thank you. I worked very hard on it. Nose height? You can't just say nose height and then... not have any words accompany it. Oh, this is... depth is such a weird, like, I don't know. I don't remember where that was. There? The longer you look at it, the more weird it looks, I feel like. Chin width? Chin width? Oh, wait. Chin height. She looks like Farrah? Sweet. I love Farrah. Chin depth is low. I mean, what does that even mean though? The problem, profiles are so hard to like, get right. She looks fine, I don't know. We para now. Just go default. No. You play the game, you go default. Do whatever you want. Don't tell me how to play. I'm not really trying to make it look like me, actually. I'm just trying to make her not look stupid at this point. Yeah, her nose is too high. Fresh ME2. What is it called? The Genesis DLC? Give her black lipstick. Oh yeah, I forgot we could do makeup. Hang on. Okay, this one is like, I wish they would give you like a number so you remember which one you're on. Oh, sweet. You can't give her black lipstick. Eyeshadow color. Which one was it on, that one? I don't want to give her black lipstick. What's the difference between that one and that one? That one's not shiny. This one's shiny. Okay. Okay, so here's where I picked Soldier, and then everyone was whining that Soldier's the most boring one, so... This music's kind of stressing me out, actually. Power training. Adrenaline rush, concussive shot, assault rifle, shotgun, sniper, heavy pistol, incendiary, cryo disruptor, pure combat specialists. Okay. Cloaking systems allow them to avoid detection for short periods of time. Tactical cloak, incinerate, AI hacking, sniper rifle, heavy pistol, submachine gun. I'm not asking you guys for your opinion. Stop telling me what to do. I'm just reading the things so that I know what they are, and then I can pick whatever I want. The more people spam Vanguard, I'm literally going to pick something else because you've spammed that 50 times. Tactical cloak, incinerate, AI hacking, weapon training, sniper rifle, heavy pistol, submachine gun, cryo disruptor. Tech and combat. With the unique ability to cloak themselves from visual and technological detection, infiltrators are deadly at any range with a wide variety of weapons. Okay. Vanguards are outfitted with L5N implants, enabling them to perform biotic charge that strikes the opponent with incredible force while bringing the Vanguard in close for short-range combat. Biotic charge, pole, shockwave. Shotgun, heavy pistol, submachine gun. High risk, high reward combat style, closing quickly on enemies and destroying them at close range with weapons and biotic abilities. Descriptions on the classes don't reflect gameplay. Well, then how the shit am I? What do you expect me? Do you think I can just predict the future of what this is going to be like? How am I supposed to know? All I can do is read this and make my decision based off of the information that they give me. Sentinels are equipped with the most advanced ablation armor system. To keep himself safe, if overloaded, the system will stun all enemies within a short distance. Tech armor, throw, warp, overload, cryoblast. Micro singularity, damaging enemies and pulling them into the air. Heavy pistol, submachine gun. Engineers can spawn combat drones to harass enemies or force them out of entrenched cover positions. That's cool. Combat drone, overload, incinerate. It's all, they all have the same exact crap. Heavy pistol, submachine gun. Okay, combat drone sounds cool. Tactical cloak. Okay, biotic charge. Are there assault rifles in this game? Yeah, assault rifle, shotgun, sniper rifle, heavy pistol. George, what's up? Thanks for the 3-month resub. Have some hamburgers. Okay, I forgot what I was doing. Okay, this person has cloaking, this person has biotic charge. Spawn a micro singularity. I don't know what that means. I mean, I get the idea of it, but pulls them into the air? Is that like what Liara does? Yeah, the Adept is the space wizards. Yeah, that's Liara's thing. Zarya's ult, but smaller. Okay. I don't know. It's the problem is that there's a bunch of, like, three or four of them sound okay. Like, I don't know. Because a few of them sound fine to me. Like, I don't feel like I have strong feelings about any of them. They all seem pretty similar. Is the thing. Darth Maul, what's up? Thanks for the sub. Welcome to the Armory. Have some hamburgers and bet me the subs. Thank you for your support. Appreciate it. There is background music, but I was getting stressed out because I was trying to read all this, and I'm trying to read chat, and chat's like saying all this stuff. And test out the classes without locking yourself in, right? That's what I was saying, like... okay, well... If you guys are saying these three were more offense, these three are more defense, let's just say not these ones, because even though Sentinel and Adept both sound pretty cool, I play more offensively. Okay, so Soldier, Infiltrator, or Vanguard. Okay, I played Soldier in the first one. People wouldn't shut up about it, so I'm going to not play Soldier. So now it's 50-50, Infiltrator, or Vanguard. I'm going to roll a d20. Hang on. Adept is all offense? Well, then why did chat say it was defense? Blame yourselves for this mistake. Adept is pretty offensive. Well, chat's liars then. Okay, well, I'm not going to do Soldier, I'm not going to do Engineer. Infiltrator, Vanguard, Sentinel is the... which one? Okay, well, I'm going to decide between these two. I'm going to roll a d20, and if it's, 1 through 10, we'll do Infiltrator, and if it's 1 through 10, Infiltrator, 11 through 20, we'll go Vanguard. Are you ready? What did I say again? 1 to 10, Infiltrator, 11 to 20, Vanguard. 18. Vanguard, here we go! You guys got what you wanted. Congratulations. How excited are you? Select. Okay, wait, hang on. This is the one where I took... Both of your parents were in the Alliance military. Childhood was spent on ships. Okay, this one, I don't... This is basically Rune. Only instead of replace, this is Rune, replace Alliance military with Assassin Clan. And then I did Ruthless, I think, right? I didn't import the Mass Effect 1 save. Clearly. I didn't do that intentionally. My D&D character's name is Rune.
There, on the monitor. Something's wrong.
She's reacting to outside stimuli, showing an awareness of her surroundings.
That only took an hour.
Miranda. I think she's waking up.
Oh my god, Miranda. Sup?
Damn it, Wilson. She's not ready yet. Give her the sedative. Shepard, don't try to move. Just lie still. Try to stay calm.
Heart rate's still climbing. Brain activity is off the charts.
This is stressing me out. Oh my god.
It's pushing into the red zone. It's not working.
Another dose. Now.
Dude, this is really stressing me out. Oh my god.
Stats falling back into normal range. Too close.
Oh, hello.
We almost lost her.
I told you your estimates were off. Run the numbers again.